गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट सेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। एज ऑल ऑफ यू नो, श्रीदेवी मैडम, प्रिंसिपल, तेलंगाना मॉडल स्कूल पूडू, इज विद अस टू प्रेजेंट अबाउट द प्रिपरेशन एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कीटोन्स। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन मैडम हैज ऑलरेडी डेल्ट विद प्रिपरेशन एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स। इन दिस सेशन she will be dealing with preparation and properties of ketones. Over to you, madam.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Please take over the session.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Good morning, everyone, and a warm good morning to all the students. Once again, welcome for the chemistry webinar. And dear children, it's a time for the carbonyl compounds. In our previous sessions, we have dealt with the preparations of aldehydes, isn't it? So let me recall the preparation of aldehydes. So the first preparation is by the partial oxidation of primary alcohols. Primary alcohols on partial oxidation gives aldehydes. And why we call this as a partial oxidation? As it is not the complete oxidation, right? When a primary alcohol undergoes oxidation in the presence of oxidizing agents like KMnO4 or K2Cr2O7, then they will give carboxylic acids. And here we are restricting this to the aldehydes only. So we are using PDC or PCC. What is PDC? Pyridium dichromate or pyridium chlorochromate. So in the presence of these two compounds, primary alcohols when undergoes oxidation gives aldehydes. Then the second preparation is by the dehydrogenation of primary alcohols. Dehydrogenation, removal of hydrogen in the presence of a catalyst like copper or silver. When primary alcohols undergo dehydrogenation, they give aldehydes. Okay, so once again, let us recapitulate the preparations of aldehydes, children, and then we will move to the preparations of ketones. I hope everyone is writing down the notes. You are ready with your pen and book. Okay, so hope you don't disappoint me. And then coming to the third preparation, it is by the dry distillation of calcium salts of carboxylic acids. Okay, see, here we have taken calcium salts of carboxylic acids, then calcium formate on distillation gives methanol, that is formaldehyde. Okay, so when you take a mixture of carboxylic acids, right, the calcium salts of carboxylic acids, and they give aldehydes, right? So then now let us move to the next preparation of these aldehydes. Then this is by the ozonolysis. Okay, see, what is ozonolysis? Adding of ozone and lysis means splitting in the presence of water and zinc. It is called as ozonolysis. See, when unsaturated hydrocarbons like ethene, when it undergoes ozonolysis, it gives formaldehyde. Ethene gives formaldehyde, right? And at the last of the session, I will tell you the applications of this also. And this is by the hydrolysis of all kinds. Ethyne, when treated with 40% sulfuric acid and 1% mercuric sulfate, gives vinyl alcohol. And here, tautomerism takes place and it gives acetaldehyde. Means the rearrangement, the shift of a proton. Tautomerism is nothing but the type of isomerism which arises by the shift of a single proton. Okay, then vinyl alcohol tautomerizes into acetaldehyde. Okay, now let us move to the next preparations of this. And this is by the hydroboration and oxidation. Hydroboration, oxidation of terminal alkynes, right? What is it? Terminal alkynes. Alkynes are aliphatic unsaturated hydrocarbons containing carbon-carbon triple bond, are called as alkynes. Terminal alkynes means the alkyne is having a triple bond at the terminal carbon atom, at the end of the carbon chain. And it is an anti-Markovnikov's rule. Okay, see, what is Markovnikov's rule? Addition to unsymmetrical alkene is governed by Markovnikov's rule. Here, it is anti-Markovnikov's addition, right? and it is a symmetric addition. We can say that it is a symmetric addition, right? And then we have moved to the next preparation, that is by the alkaline hydrolysis. Alkaline hydrolysis of terminal gem dihalides. Okay, so terminal gem dihalides. What are gem dihalides? When the dihalide contains the halogens on a single carbon atom, when the two halogen atoms are attached to the same carbon atom, we can say that the same carbon atom, it is called as gem dihalide. When it is attached to two adjacent carbons, then it is a vicinal dihalide. So here it is a terminal gem dihalide. Okay, so by the alkaline hydrolysis, alkaline means in the presence of a base, the hydrolysis is taking place. And then this is the next preparation. It is a name reaction. I told you to write this in your book where you are writing all the name reactions. Okay, Nana? So Rosenmund's reduction. See here, you have to remember one thing. By this method, we can prepare only aldehydes and not ketones. So Rosenmund's reduction. Acid chloride. Acid chloride means when a carboxylic acid reacts with an acid, like means HCl, right? So what does it forms? Acid chloride. This acid chloride on reduction, what is it? Reduction, addition of hydrogens. And in the presence of Lindlar's catalyst. What is Lindlar's catalyst? Palladium barium sulfate is poisoned by quinoline and is called as Lindlar's catalyst. So Rosenmund's reduction gives only aldehydes. Please remember, not ketones. Okay. So here I have taken acetyl chloride. What is the IUPAC name? So let us write the IUPAC name once again. So ethanoyl chloride. Why? Because how many carbons? Two carbons, right? So ethanoyl chloride on reduction in the presence of Lindlar's catalyst gives ethanol. That is our acetaldehyde. What is the common name? Acetaldehyde. Okay, Nana? So, and then we have moved to the another preparation of this aldehydes. This is a Stephens reduction, right? And here you have to remember one thing, right? So by this, we can prepare only the aldehyde, Stephens reduction, right? Stephens reduction. Okay. And then we have moved to the preparations of ketones. Okay. So preparation of ketones. So today we are going to learn about the remaining preparation methods of ketones, Nana. I think I have dealt with the first preparation, that is by the partial oxidation of secondary alcohols. So in today's session, we are learning about the preparation methods of ketones. So what is the first one? By the partial oxidation of secondary alcohols. So what is a secondary carbon? A carbon which is bonded with two alkyl groups. This is one alkyl group and this is another alkyl group. So secondary, two, please remember, secondary, okay? And then the carbon will be having one hydrogen. That also you have to remember. And this on partial oxidation, again in the presence of PDC or PCC, dichloromethane gives ketone, okay? So here I have taken isopropyl alcohol as an example. Isopropyl alcohol or 2-propanol, 2-propanol, 1, 2, 3, 3 carbons. And the second carbon is attached to the OH group. So it's 2-propanol. This on partial oxidation in the presence of pyridium dichromate or pyridium chlorochromate gives propanone. That is our acetone. What is it? Acetone. Okay, Nana? Acetone. So this is the first preparation. I hope we have dealt with this preparation. And now let us learn about the remaining methods of preparations of ketones. Okay. Most probably, I will end this session with the preparation methods of ketones. And in our next session, we will learn about the properties of aldehydes and ketones. Okay. So now let us move to the next one. By the dehydrogenation. By dehydrogenation Again, dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogens, right? By the dehydrogenation of secondary alcohols. Okay, by the dehydrogenation of secondary alcohols, ketones are prepared. Okay, so then how they are prepared, let us see. By the dehydrogenation, again we have to take a secondary alcohol. So I'm taking isopropyl alcohol. What is it? Isopropyl alcohol or 2-propanol. Isopropyl alcohol or 2-propanol, right? So CH3OH. Okay, so isopropyl alcohol, that is a secondary alcohol. What alcohol, Nana? Secondary alcohol. So please try to write down the statements. Okay, so a secondary alcohol on dehydrogenation in the presence of copper or silver at 300 degrees centigrade. See, what does it give? So it gives a ketone, CH3 double bond O. It gives a ketone plus, okay, H2, hydrogen is eliminated. Okay, so then again, when this reaction takes place in the presence of air, okay, in air, in the presence of catalyst, at copper or silver, in the presence of catalyst, copper or silver, and in air, so again, you will get this ketone, CH3, C double bond O, CH3. But the byproduct is H2O. I told you that air contains moisture, that is a water vapor, okay? So that's why means it contains oxygen, isn't it? So H2O is eliminated here. Now let us move to the next preparation of these ketones, okay? So then the next one is by the dry distillation of, dry distillation of calcium salts of carboxylic acids. You can see that calcium salts of carboxylic acid. So by the dry distillation of calcium salts, so here I'm taking calcium alkanoate RCOO taken twice. Okay, taken twice, Ca. So calcium salt of carboxylic acid on distillation. Okay, so what does it give? It gives ketone RC double bond O R plus calcium carbonate. And then let us move to the reaction here. When you take this calcium acetate, CaCOOCH3, taken twice, okay, calcium acetate, right? And on distillation, so what do you get? You will get acetone, CH3C double bond O CH3. So what is this? Acetone and calcium carbonate is eliminated. CaCO3 is eliminated, right? So when you take calcium acetate, you'll get acetone. Okay, so please remember, right? So then this method is suitable for the preparation of symmetrical ketones. Please, I will write the note here. This method is useful to prepare symmetrical ketones. Okay, Nana? So this is the dry distillation of calcium salts. Now let us move to the next preparation of these ketones, okay? So then, by the reduction of carboxylic acids, by the reduction of carboxylic acids. So what is reduction? So addition of hydrogens or removal of oxygens, right? By the reduction of carboxylic acids. Okay, Nana? By the reduction of carboxylic acids. So this is the third preparation. So reduction of carboxylic acids, right? So carboxylic acid, RCOOH, okay? And then another carboxylic acid I'm taking, R-COOH. So it mentions that the alkyl group is different, okay? And that's the only difference. In the presence of manganese dioxide at 300 degrees centigrade. So reduction takes place and what do you get? You will get a ketone, RCOR dash. See, this is the alkyl group, okay? And then what is eliminated apart from this? Water and carbon dioxide. Water and carbon dioxide. Okay, now let us move to the preparation ones here. See, I'm taking acetic acid, CH3COOH, acetic acid, that is ethanoic acid. How many carbons? Two carbons, ethanoic acid. And a mixture of another carboxylic acid, that is propionic acid or propanoic acid. Okay, propionic acid or propanoic acid, C2H5COOH. So this is propanoic acid. IUPAC name, alkanoic acids, isn't it? How many carbons? Three carbons, 2 + 1, 3. So propanoic acid. In the presence of manganese dioxide at 300 degrees centigrade, right? What does it give? It gives CH3CO, okay, C2H5. So what is this? This is a 2-butanone. What is it, Nana? 2-butanone, okay, plus H2O and CO2. 2-butanone. See, here I told you that is an alkyl group from another carboxylic acid. See here, this is a CH3 and this is a CO, this is C2H5. Understood, all of you? So this is the another preparation. This is by the reduction of carboxylic acids. Okay, so then except formic acid, here you have to remember for your objective, right? So please make a note of this. Except formic acid. Okay, other carboxylic acids form ketones. Okay, Nana? Form ketones. Right? Okay. So this is a third preparation, that is by the reduction of carboxylic acids. Now let us move to the next preparation. I will recapitulate and at the end of the session, okay? So then this is, I think, the fifth preparation of ketones. So this is by the hydrolysis means adding of water, and lysis takes place. Hydro means water, lysis means breakage or cleavage, right? By the hydrolysis of alkenes. And what is this process? Do you remember the name of this reaction? Yes, Walker's process. Which process? Walker's process. W-A-C-K-E-R. Yes, Walker's process. So I think you are adding again another reaction in your name reactions. Okay, Walker's process. So by the hydrolysis of alkenes, by the hydrolysis of alkenes. So I'm taking an alkene here. So this is a CH3CH double bond CH2. How many carbons? Three carbons, isn't it? Prop, and then double bond, ene, propene. And this on treatment with palladium chloride. Palladium chloride and hydrolysis. Okay. So what does it give? So, and here, what are the reagents we will use? Copper chloride or calcium chloride. Okay. Copper chloride or calcium chloride. And then what are the products we are going to get here? So it's our desired compound. That is our ketone, isn't it? So CH3, C double bond O, CH3. That is our acetone. Our IUPAC name, propanone. What is it? Propanone plus palladium and then HCl. So this is the Walker's process. By the hydrolysis of alkenes, aliphatic unsaturated hydrocarbons containing carbon-carbon double bond are called as alkenes. What is it? Alkenes. Okay, Nana? Then, so let us move to the next one. Okay, so this is the reductive ozonolysis. Okay, ozonolysis. Ozone reacts with unsaturated hydrocarbons, means the compounds which contains double bond or triple bond. Okay, and forms an ozonide. This ozonide on hydrolysis gives carbonyl compounds. That is called as ozonolysis. Okay, so reductive ozonolysis of dialkyl substituted alkenes. Okay, alkenes. Okay, Nana, dialkyl substituted alkenes, ozonolysis. So the compounds which contain double bond or triple bond reacts with ozone and forms ozonide, unstable ozonide. So this on hydrolysis gives carbonyl compounds, and this is called as ozonolysis. What is it? Ozonolysis. So now let us move to the reaction here. So we are taking dialkyl substituted. See, di, two alkyl groups. Dialkyl substituted alkene. Understood, Nana? Dialkyl substituted alkene. And this on ozonolysis. So treatment with ozone, and then the second step, hydrolysis in the presence of zinc. Okay, so what do you get? You will get 2 moles of ketone, RCOR. It depends upon the reactant what you take here. Okay, so this is the reductive ozonolysis. And now let us see the reaction here. So CH3, CH double bond, CH3. Okay, see, dialkyl substituted alkene. These are the two alkyl groups. What is the name of this compound? 2-butene. 1, 2, 3, 4. Second carbon is having a double bond. So 2-butene. So this on treatment with ozone. Okay. So where does this add? This will add at the double bond. Right? Like the CH3, CH, okay, O, O, then CH, CH3, okay, again O, like this. Okay, Nana? Now, how the bond will break? And this on hydrolysis, isn't it? In the presence of zinc. So I will show you how the cleavage takes place. Okay. So see here, the cleavage will take place like this. Right? So this is the cleavage, breakage. So what do you get here? So you will get CH3, C double bond OH, CH3, C double bond OH. So what is this? So you will get 2 moles of acetaldehyde, isn't it? Yes. Of course, you will get 2 moles of CH3, CHO. So what is this? Aldehyde. we are preparing a ketone, isn't it? So how to get a ketone, I will show you. I told you that only. So how to go for the application of this reaction, I told you that I will show you. So CH3, CH2, CH double bond, okay? CH, CH2, CH3, right? Understood? So dialkyl substituted CH3, CH2, CH double bond, CH, CH2, CH3, right? So dialkyl substituted alkene. And then this on ozonolysis, okay? And on hydrolysis, right? In the presence of zinc. Simply, I will show you the products where the cleavage takes place, children. So the cleavage will take place here. Understood? So what do you get? You will get CH3, C double bond O, CH3, like this. Okay? So I hope it is clear for you how to get a ketone from this. And I will show you another reaction also. See, if I write a compound like this, I'm showing all sort of applications. And where the cleavage also takes place, I'm showing you. CH3, C, H, double bond, CH, CH2, CH3, right? So then, see here, when it undergoes ozonolysis, and on again hydrolysis in the presence of zinc, the cleavage will take place here, like this. Understood? So you will get CH3CHO, one mole of CH3CHO, and then you will get CH3CH2CHO. So you will get one mole of ethanol and one mole of propanol. Understood? So this is the application part of this ozonolysis, children, right? Okay. So then coming to the next one, I hope you have understood. By the reductive ozonolysis of dialkyl substituted alkenes, you'll get ketones. What do you get? Ketones. And then let us move to the next preparation method. So that is by the hydrolysis of alkynes. Just remember, wherever the double bond or triple bond is present, you just try to add the oxygens there and you just split the compound, okay? Alkynes, okay? So then there is a name for this reaction also, by the hydrolysis of alkynes. So this is called as a Kucherov's reaction, okay? Another name reaction is being added for you, by the hydrolysis of alkynes. So this is our alkyne, RC triple bond CH. So alkynes, aliphatic unsaturated hydrocarbons containing carbon-carbon triple bond are called as alkynes. And this on treatment with 40% sulfuric acid and 1% mercuric sulfate. I hope many of you have identified that all these reactions you have seen earlier in the case of preparation of aldehydes, isn't it? Yes, of course, you are correct. And then what do you get here? You'll get a ketone, RC double bond O, CH3, right? So by the hydrolysis of alkynes, so this is alkyne. Here you have to note down an important point. For your IPE, if you just learn two preparations of aldehydes and two preparations of ketones, it is enough. Okay. But for your objective examination, you have to learn all the preparations, children. Right? That is the thing. So note all alkynes except acetylene or ethyne. What is IUPAC name? Ethyne, two carbons and a triple bond, ine. gives ketones. Please remember, gives ketones. And the product formed will be according to the Markovnikov's rule. Please note down this, an important point. The product formed will be according to the Markovnikov's rule. The product formed will be according to the Markovnikov's rule. Means the negative part of the reagent is added to the carbon, which is having less number of hydrogens. Okay. The product formed will be according to the Markovnikov's rule. Markovnikov's rule. Okay, Nana. So this is the next preparation, that is the hydrolysis of alkynes, which is called as Kucherov's reaction. And then we will move to the next preparation. Okay. So this is by the, I hope I remember that this is the eighth preparation, by the hydroboration, oxidation of non-terminal alkynes, HBO reaction. Those children who are aiming for IITs and for a NEET examination, so please start your preparation. Okay, don't waste your time, Nana, because the time is very, very precious. We can't bring it back. Please remember, already you are going to like, it is decided that you had to attend the schools and colleges from February 2nd, isn't it? So please keep this in your mind, and I hope that you'll have practicals in the month of March, right? March ending, you'll have your practical examinations. And from April from April 15th onwards, I hope you will have your board exams also. Okay, so please keep this in your mind and try to prepare. So by the hydroboration oxidation of non-terminal alkynes, that is HBO reaction. So non-terminal means the triple bond is not present at the terminal carbon. Okay. And here, please identify the difference. Whereas in aldehydes, you have studied that by the hydroboration oxidation of terminal alkynes. Okay, that is the difference here. This is non-terminal alkynes. Okay. Excuse me. So then, so by the hydroboration, so it is treated with boron hydride. Okay. And then in the second step, it undergoes hydrolysis in the presence of a base, right? So what do you get? You will get an alcohol here, like this. Triple bond, okay, OH. And this undergoes rearrangement. When you write like this, you have to understand that it is rearrangement, Nana. Right? Rearrangement. So rearranging of atoms. Rearrangement. Like this. Okay. So what do you get? You'll get a ketone. Yes. So this is a non-terminal alkyne. See here, the triple bond is present at the center. It is not present at the end like this. Okay. And it is treated with boron hydride, and which on hydrolysis in the presence of a base, it gives an alcohol, and which rearranges to a ketone, right? So please remember this. And here you have to remember the product formed will be according to the anti-Markovnikov's rule. So I'm not leaving each and every important point, Nana, right? The product formed will be according to the formed will be according to the Anti-Markovnikov's rule. Anti-Markovnikov's rule. Right? Anti-Markovnikov's rule. Okay. So then another important point, unsymmetrical means it is not symmetrical. It is not carrying equal number of hydrogens, right? Unsymmetrical, non-terminal alkynes, unsymmetrical, non-terminal alkynes, okay? Non-terminal alkynes give mixture of ketones, please remember. So what does it give? Give mixture of ketones. Please remember, give mixture of ketones. Okay, Nana? So by the hydroboration, oxidation of non-terminal alkynes, right? So then let us move to the next preparation of these ketones. Then, if I remember, then it is the ninth preparation. Then this preparation is by the alkaline. Alkaline means in the presence of a base. Okay, by the alkaline hydrolysis. Hydrolysis means addition of water and breaking of the compound, splitting of the compound. Lysis means splitting. By the alkaline hydrolysis of non-terminal, what is it? Non-terminal gem dihalides. Gem. Okay, so the two halogens are attached to the same carbon. We call it as a geminal dihalide or gem dihalide. So by the hydrolysis, alkaline hydrolysis of non-terminal. Here you have to remember non-terminal means the bond is not present at the end of the chain. Non-terminal, right? Non-terminal gem dihalides. Okay, so like this, R, C, okay, X, what is this? Halogens, right? And then R, non-terminal gem dihalides are undergoing alkaline hydrolysis. See, what is KOH? KOH is a base, isn't it? So that's why we call it as alkaline hydrolysis. So this is a non-terminal geminal dihalide or gem dihalide. Okay, so the halogens are attached to the same carbon. What is eliminated? -2KX potassium halide is eliminated. And what do you get? So the OH group is attached to the carbon, same carbon. Then I told you that it will be unstable if the two OH groups are attached to the same carbon. So it is unstable. And then water molecule will be eliminated from such compound. So OH and H are eliminated. And what do you get, Nana? So you will get a ketone. What do you get? R, C, double bond, O, R. Okay. See, I will eliminate the water molecule. Again, I can see OH and H will be eliminated like this. Understood? What is eliminated, Nana? -H2O, right? So I can remove this again. See, understood? Again, I can keep this. So -H2O, okay? So what is the product obtained? You'll get a ketone, right? So this is the alkaline hydrolysis of non-terminal gem dihalides, okay? Alkaline hydrolysis of non-terminal gem dihalides. And now let us move to the next preparation of these. So this is from acid halide. I hope this is the 10th preparation. From acid halide RCOCl. What is this? Acid chloride. From acid chloride and dialkyl cadmium. Cadmium. Okay, so then how it is prepared, let us see here. So what is this? RMGX, Grignard's reagent, isn't it? Grignard's reagent, RMGX. So when 2 moles of Grignard's reagent is treated with cadmium chloride, CdCl2. So you will get this dialkyl cadmium. Okay, what do you get? Dialkyl cadmium. How? R2CD. Okay, dialkyl cadmium plus what is eliminated? 2 moles of MgX, okay, Cl, right, is eliminated. This is the dialkyl cadmium. We'll go for another color. Dialkyl, okay, dialkyl cadmium. Understood? Di means 2, Nana. Alkyl groups, R. R means alkyl group. Dialkyl cadmium, okay. So then, now it is treated with the acid chloride, like this, R, C, double bond, O, Cl. Okay, then another mole I will write here, R, C, double bond, O, Cl. Okay, so plus dialkyl cadmium, Cd, R dash, R dash. What is this dialkyl cadmium? And now, let us see what will be eliminated. So, what is the thing which we had to eliminate here? See, this is eliminated. Understood? Right? See here, what is eliminated? So, cadmium chloride is eliminated. And what do you get? Simple. So, you will get R, C, double bond O, R dash. How many moles, Nana? 2 moles. 2 moles of ketone you will get. 2 moles of ketone plus cadmium chloride, CdCl2, CdCl2, okay, yes. So this is the preparation from acid chloride and dialkyl cadmium. See this, this is also very important, Nana, dialkyl cadmium. If you compare this reaction with the preparations of aldehydes, you will remember the Rosenmund's reduction, isn't it? Acid chloride is treated with their palladium chloride, and which is poisoned by quinoline, isn't it? It is poisoned by quinoline. So like this, here we are using dialkyl cadmium. And I told you that by Rosenmund's reduction, we cannot prepare ketones, isn't it? Yes, of course. And now let us see the next one, okay? So with the alkyl or aryl cyanide, alkyl or aryl cyanide, okay, cyanide. What is cyanide? R-C-E-N, alkyl or aryl cyanide. And how it is prepared, let us see. And then I will show you a compound. You have to tell me the name. RMGX. What is this? Yes, correct. Grignard's reagent. So this is having lot of synthetic application. Grignard's reagent. So Grignard's reagent, when treated with this alkyl or aryl cyanide, R dash C triple bond N. Okay. So what do you get? So you will get a ketone. You will get an addition product first, right? R dash C R, okay? So then triple bond becomes double bond. This is NMGX. And then this undergoes hydrolysis. Hydrolysis. And what does it form? It forms a ketone, right? So with alkyl or aryl cyanide, so this is from Grignard's reagent. So from Grignard's reagent. Please remember, from Grignard's reagent. Okay, so then, so please remember these preparations. Okay, Nana? So then, here I have to mention one thing, an important point. Please note down. Ketones cannot be prepared. Ketones cannot be prepared by Stephen's reduction and Rosenmund's reduction. Stephen's reduction and Rosenmund's reduction. So please remember this, Rosenmund's reduction. So I hope you have understood the preparations of ketones, children. Okay. So these are all the preparations of ketones which we have dealt today, right? So now let us move to the properties of ketones. Ma'am, shall I move with the properties of ketones also? Aldehydes and ketones. Okay. So let us move with the properties of aldehydes and ketones, children. So the chemical properties, okay. So chemical properties. Chemical properties. See here, aldehydes and ketones both possess the highly polar carbonyl group, C double bond O group. So this is the highly polar carbonyl group, okay. So and they have means they should have similar chemical properties, right? Like the C, okay. So then this, like pi electrons will be shifted towards this oxygen, right? And then it attains a partial positive charge and it attains a partial negative charge, right? So the highly polar carbonyl group, highly polar carbonyl group, highly polar carbonyl group. Okay, highly polar carbonyl group. See, the carbonyl group has two active centers. One is the positively charged carbon atom. The other one is the partially negatively charged oxygen atom. So the partially positively charged carbon and partial negatively charged oxygen atom. See, it has two active centers. See, the addition may takes place at oxygen or at a carbon atom, isn't it? See, it is readily attacked by electron-rich nucleophiles. So it is attacked by electron-rich nucleophiles. Nucleophiles, electron-rich species. What are nucleophiles? Electron-rich species, nucleophiles. So it is attacked by electron-rich nucleophiles. Okay, so please remember this. And this is the nucleophilic addition reactions. Hence, what are these reactions? Nucleophilic addition reactions. I hope you have understood this in a brief manner. So they undergo nucleophilic addition reactions. Why? Because the carbonyl group is highly polar. It has two active centers. One is a partial positively charged carbon. Another one is a partial negatively charged oxygen. Okay, so then this carbon is attacked by the electron-rich nucleophiles. Hence, the addition is called as nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay, Nana? So now, let us see this nucleophilic addition mechanism. Nucleophilic addition. Nucleophilic addition mechanism. So let us see the mechanism. Mechanism means it includes all the steps. That is the rate determining step. Okay. So the slowest step in a reaction is called as a rate determining step. And the number of molecules participating in the rate determining step is called as its molecularity. Do you remember this? We have studied this in SN1 and SN2 reactions, isn't it? There is a nucleophilic substitution and nucleophilic addition, right? So this is nucleophilic addition mechanism. Okay, so now let us move with this. How they are formed, let us see. See, if this is an aldehyde, like From now onwards, we'll write like this, Nana. See this? This is H. If this is a H, aldehyde. If this is R dash, it is a ketone. I'll write here. So this is a ketone and this is an aldehyde. Okay? Yes. Right? If this is a H, aldehyde. And if this is a R dash, it is a ketone. And now let us see the mechanism here. So it is attacked by the nucleophile. And nucleus loving species or electron rich species. Okay, so then what is the mechanism? So where does it attack? It attacks the electron deficient carbon atom. Okay, and then RCO minus. Okay, and this is the nucleophile which is attached to the electron deficient carbon. Okay, and this is our HR R dash. And what happens? This will be forming RCOH. Okay. And this is our Z. And this is H or R dash. Okay. Right. So this is the nucleophilic addition mechanism. See here, you had to remember one thing. If the attacking nucleophile is strong, okay, so it will readily attack the carbonyl carbon. Right. So it results in addition product and can be readily protonated. Protonated means what? This hydrogen. Protonated means it will accept a proton from water by the solvent. Okay. So that is the meaning of protonation. Okay, Nana? So if it is a poor nucleophile, not strong, poor nucleophile, then it requires an acid catalyst. Anyway, I will write down those two points also here for your better understanding purpose or for better convincing purpose, right? Understanding or purpose, please write down. Please note down these two points, Nana. So if the attacking nucleophile is strong. Attacking nucleophile is strong. Okay. So then addition product is formed. Addition product is formed. Addition product is formed by the protonation. By the protonation from solvent. Okay, Nana? From solvent. Please remember. Next, what is the second condition? If the attacking nucleophile is weak, okay, means is poor. If the attacking nucleophile is not strong, or we can say that it is poor, then an acid catalyst will make the nucleophilic addition at a reasonable rate. Understood? At a reasonable rate. And here, the acid, it protonates, means it donates a proton. Understand? The acid protonates the carbonyl oxygen. Okay, Nana? Right? So these are the two conditions what you have to remember. If the attacking nucleophile is strong, then the addition product is formed by the protonation from the solvent. Okay? Then if the attacking nucleophile is poor, if it is not strong enough, right? So then how the protonation takes place? Then the acid catalyst will make the nucleophilic addition reaction to happen at a reasonable rate. and the acid will donate a proton to the carbonyl oxygen. So the acid protonates the carbonyl oxygen. So this is regarding the nucleophilic addition reactions of these aldehydes and ketones. Okay, Nana? So now let us see this. Right? So then the first one is addition of sodium bisulfite. Now let us see one by one. There are number of reactions, but I promise you that all these reactions are very, very simple and easy. Okay, so even though it is lengthy, but don't keep this in your mind. So many reactions are there. So how can I learn all of this? I told you, know that it's very easy to remember these reactions. Addition of sodium bisulfite. Sodium bisulfite. Okay, so then we are seeing this addition of sodium bisulfite. So acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, acetaldehyde reacts with sodium bisulfite. Sodium bisulfite. Okay. So NaHSO3, sodium bisulfite in the presence of dilute acid. So dilute H plus means in the presence of a dilute acid. So what did I tell you? CH3, okay, COH, right? And then this is SO3 Na, and this is our H. What is the name of this? Acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite. Acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite. Sodium bisulfite. Okay, sodium bisulfite. So here, how to split this? This is NaHSO3, sodium bisulfite, isn't it? So you just split this like this. So NaSO3 minus and then H plus. Understood? See, I have added this hydrogen to oxygen and the NaSO3 to the carbon. So this is acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite. So the first one is addition of sodium bisulfite. What is this? Addition of sodium bisulfite. Right? So we'll write with another color. So this is acetaldehyde. So I think you have understood how to add this two here. Right? So I have added the nucleophile part to the carbon atom and the electrophilic part to the oxygen. Understood? So this is the first reaction. And now let us see the next one, that is addition of HCl. Addition of HCl, hydrogen cyanide. Hydrogen cyanide. Here also, which is a nucleophilic part? Cyanide is the nucleophilic part and H is the electrophilic part. So acetaldehyde reacts with HCl. HCN, hydrogen cyanide. Okay, so in the presence of a base here, base, okay, right? So this is the nucleophilic part, okay, this is the electrophilic part, this is added to the carbon, and this is added to the oxygen, right? So what is the product here? CH3, CH, okay, OH, CN. Right? CH3CHOHCl. So what is this? Acetaldehyde cyanohydrine. Okay. Acetaldehyde cyanohydrine. Acetaldehyde cyanohydrine. Okay, Nana. Acetaldehyde cyanohydrine. Right? So then see here, this reaction occurs very slowly. And hence it is catalyzed by a base. Please remember this. As it happens very slowly, we are making it somewhat speed by adding a base, right? So as it occurs very slowly, so catalyzed by a base. Here cyanide is a strong nucleophile, remember. I will write here cyanide is a strong nucleophile. Cyanide is a strong nucleophile. An electron-rich species is called as a nucleophile. Understood? Now let us move to the next properties of these aldehydes. Okay. So then, addition of Grignard's reagent. Addition of Grignard's reagent. So this is an important property. And I think we have dealt with this in alcohols, if you remember properly. So addition of Grignard's reagent, right? So here I will show you with the acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, okay? So in the presence of Grignard's reagent, that is methyl magnesium bromide, and on hydrolysis, so you will get a secondary alcohol, CH3CH3OH. What is this? Isopropyl alcohol, a secondary alcohol. What do you get? Secondary alcohol, right? So this is a secondary carbon, children, right? Which is bonded with two alkyl groups. This is one alkyl group, this is another alkyl group. So acetaldehyde, when treated with Grignard's reagent and on again hydrolysis, undergoes hydrolysis, it gives secondary alcohol. Here, please remember, I hope some of you might have recalled this, because if you have taken formaldehyde, isn't it? So what do you get? If you take formaldehyde, I will tell you, what do you get? So HCHO is a formaldehyde, isn't it? So when it is treated with methyl magnesium bromide, that is Grignard's reagent, okay, so what do you get? You will get an addition product like this, CHH. This is CH3, this is OMGBr, and now this undergoes hydrolysis. The bond will split here, so remember, right? You'll get H here and OH here. So you will get ethanol, CH3, CH2, OH plus MgOHBr. Yes, of course, you are very good, correct. This is the primary alcohol. What is it? Primary alcohol. So formaldehyde plus Grignard's reagent. Formaldehyde plus Grignard's reagent gives primary alcohol. Then acetaldehyde plus Grignard's reagent gives secondary alcohol. Okay, remember, please. So this is formaldehyde and Grignard's reagent gives primary alcohol, and acetaldehyde and Grignard's reagent gives secondary alcohol. Okay, so I will move to another property, and then explaining this, I will wind off. So addition of alcohols. So the next one is addition of alcohols. So we are adding alcohols. Addition of alcohols. So what do you get? Let us see. And this is catalyzed by acid in 1:1 ratio, right? Catalyzed by acid in 1:1 ratio, like this. So acetaldehyde plus alcohol, okay? So what is this? Alcohol. In the presence of dry HCl and dilute HCl, so you will get an unstable compound. How do you get CH3? This is a CH3, this is a CH, isn't it? CH, and then add this H2O, okay? And then add this alkyl group to another oxygen, right? So this is unstable hemiacetal. What is this? Unstable hemiacetal. Unstable hemiacetal. Hemiacetal. Okay, Nana? So this is addition of alcohols. And this is catalyzed by acid 1:1, remember. Now let us see when it is, so I will write the name here, acetaldehyde, right, is adding up an alcohol, R-OH. Now, catalyzed by acid in 1:2 ratio. Let us see, 1:2. So what happens? Let us see here. Now, so this is acetaldehyde plus 2 moles of alcohol, R-OH. Okay, again, dry HCl and dilute HCl. Okay, so what do you get? You will get a stable compound, CH3COR-. Okay, so this is OR- and this is H. Okay, so this is a stable acetal. This is not hemiacetal, this is acetal, stable acetal. And what is its nature? See here, it is a gem dialkoxy alkane. Okay, Nana? Alkoxy. So, alkyl group is present along with oxygen. So, alkoxy. How many? 2. So, gem. To the same carbon. Again, the word gem. Okay? So, gem dialkoxy alkane. So, this is the addition of alcohols. So, we have seen 2 conditions, children. So, one is catalyzed by acid. 1:1 ratio. The other one is catalyzed by acid in 1:2 ratio. Okay, Nana? So this is about the properties of aldehydes. So we have dealt today up to the addition of alcohols. So in my next class, I will deal with other properties of aldehydes and ketones, children. So let us recall quickly. Okay. Ma'am, can I recall one? So this is the preparation of ketones. The first one, what we have learned today, by the partial oxidation of secondary alcohols. A secondary alcohol and partial oxidation, okay, in the presence of PDC or PCC gives a ketone. We have taken isopropyl alcohol, and what is the compound obtained? So the compound obtained is acetone. Okay. Acetone. And now let us move to the remaining preparations, what we have learned today. So the next preparation is by the dehydrogenation of secondary alcohols. So dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogen in the presence of catalyst copper or silver at 300 degrees centigrade. So we'll get again our ketone. The next preparation is by the dry distillation of calcium salts. So the calcium salts on dry distillation gives a ketone, and this method is useful to prepare symmetrical ketones. Then the next one is by the reduction of carboxylic acids with manganese dioxide at 300 degrees centigrade. Right here we have taken a mixture of carboxylic acids, that is ethanoic acid and propanoic acid. Okay. So when undergoes reduction in the presence of manganese dioxide at 300 degrees centigrade gives 2-butanol. And then here you have to remember, except formic acid, the other carboxylic acids will give ketones. Okay. So now let us move to the next preparation. This is by the ozonolysis. Okay. So what is this? By the reductive ozonolysis of dialkyl substituted alkenes. So reductive ozone analysis of dialkyl substituted alkenes gives our ketones, right? And here I have shown you the application. When you take 2-butene, what do you get? Okay. So see, here I'll give you a task, children, to do at home, right? You just tell me, what do you get when you take this compound? So dialkyl substituted alkene, isn't it? So please write down this and tell me the answer tomorrow. I'm very happy that many of you are asking questions in the chat box or in the comment box, right? I'm very happy with you all, children. So 1, 2, 3, 4. See, this is a disubstituted like alkene. Okay. So see here, please tell me the answer. When you take this compound and go for ozonolysis, what do you get? Means, what are the compounds? What are the products you get here? You tell me in my next class, children, right? So this is the task for you, right? Just try to do this. It's very easy. Okay, Nana, I hope everyone will do this and tell me the answer, right? You can write down the answer in the chat box, children. Okay, right. So when you go for ozonolysis by taking this compound, what is the product you'll get here? Then again, we have seen the remaining preparations, that is by the hydroboration oxidation of all kinds. Okay, and here it is a non-terminal alkynes, means the triple bond is not present at the end of the carbon chain here. So, and here I told you to remember few important points. The product formed will be according to the anti-Markovnikov rule, means it is not following the Markovnikov rule. The negative part of the reagent is added to the carbon which is having less number of hydrogens. That is Markovnikov rule, but it is against the anti-Markovnikov rule. Okay, and then here unsymmetrical non-terminal alkynes will give a mixture of ketones. What does they give? They give a mixture of ketones. Okay, so then the next one after that we have dealt with this. So this is by the treatment of acid chloride with dialkyl cadmium. So from acid chloride and dialkyl cadmium, so when you treat these two, you get ketone, right? And then the last thing which I told you is by Stefan's reduction and Rosenwand's reduction, we cannot prepare ketones. By these two methods, we can prepare only aldehydes, okay, but not ketones. Please remember this and keep in your mind. And the last preparation I have shown you from Grignard's reagent, children. So from Grignard's reagent, when it is treated with alkyl or aryl cyanide, so it gives ketone. And then ketones cannot be prepared by Stefan's reduction and Rosenmund's reduction. So this is the 11th preparation which we have learned. Okay. Then after that, we entered into the chemical properties. I told you that the carbonyl group is commonly present in both aldehydes and ketones. Hence, they are collectively called as carbonyl compounds, isn't it? Yes. So this carbonyl group is a highly polar one because of the electron shift from carbon to oxygen, because of the electronegativity difference between the two atoms, that is carbon and oxygen. Carbon is the fourth group element, and whereas oxygen is the sixth group element. Okay, oxygen is more electronegative. Then the shift of electrons towards oxygen makes it a polar one, right? As it is a highly polar group, and then the two centers will become active, that is a carbon and oxygen, both of them will become active. And then here the nucleophilic addition will take place at the carbon because it becomes electron deficient, isn't it? So it becomes electron deficient, and whereas oxygen becomes electron rich. So this is the nucleophilic addition mechanism. Nucleophile and nucleus loving species or electron rich species is attacking the carbon, and the addition product is obtained. and I have shown you four properties, I think. The first one is addition of sodium bisulfite. Okay, so what is it giving when it reacts with the sodium bisulfite? So it gives addition of sodium bisulfite to acetaldehyde. So acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite, right? Okay, so then addition of HCl, acetaldehyde cyanohydrin. Okay, so then with the Grignard's reagent also we have seen, that is addition of Grignard's reagent. So when formaldehyde reacts with Grignard's reagent, it gives primary alcohol, whereas acetaldehyde reacts with Grignard's reagent and gives secondary alcohol. Okay, so then we move to the addition of alcohols, an important one. So when it reacts with the 1:1 ratio, so when the acid is in 1:1 ratio here, when it is catalyzed by acid, 1:1 ratio, in 1:1 ratio, it gives unstable hemiacetal, and when it is in 1:2 ratio, it gives stable acetal. Okay, so that's all for the today's class, children. I hope you have understood this. Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for the conversation. It was very detailed. The preparation of alcohols and, for ketones, sorry, and as you said, ketones, I think that there will be a bit like, can ketones be prepared by Rosenmann's reaction or not, Stephenson's reaction or not, so such kind of mistake. Yes, ma'am. Thank you for clearly explaining even the properties of ketones. Yes, ma'am. Please prepare your own notes.
And whatever madam has told, it is very detailed. In addition to whatever the textbook information is there, there are many additions to the textbook syllabus, and it is in detailed way. If you follow this notes, I think it is easy to crack any of IP or any other competitive examinations. So please follow these notes and practice. Practice organic chemistry reactions are very important. Practice, practice, practice.
Yes, ma'am. They have to practice a lot, ma'am. Then only they will be able to write the reactions like, okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for giving the opportunity.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am.